Hello, welcome to Arvind Singh Academy, and we are discussing mathematical tool, and this is the lecture number 12. I hope you have already watched part 1 to part 11 before watching this part 12. Although this is a new topic that I am going to discuss today, this is integration. We are going to discuss today integration. So some basic knowledge you can about differentiation, if you have, you can understand it well. There is no problem. So, but it is advice that you should learn, you should watch, you should understand each and every topic which we have discussed till 1 to 11 in this lecture. So, it will be useful and you will be able to understand it well. So, here I am going to start with the integration. What is integration and how to, what you have to learn for it with respect to physics. So, integration is nothing else. It is the reverse process of differentiation. Integration is simply is the reverse process of differentiation. Right now? So integration is reverse process of differentiation. That is the simple thing. So on the basis of that, there are integration are two type. So integration are basically two type. One is called indefinite integration, and another is called definite integration. So there are two type of integration. One is indefinite integration. That is indefinite integration. Integration and another is definite integration. Right? And thereafter there is some implications as well. So indefinite and definite integrations. Let us start today about indefinite integration and in indefinite integrations and what is the difference between definite and indefinite, that we'll discuss one by one. Here I am going to start with indefinite integration. And why it is said to be indefinite integration. There is one operator, integral dx is an operator. Operator like dy dx, right now? So integral dx is an operator. The symbol is called integral, right now? So just let us have a comparison with that. If you have dy dx of x to the power n, then that is n x to the power n minus 1. So integral, if you are making integration of x to the power n, here power is decreased, here power will increase and divided by, because here power is multiplier, here power is divided, plus c. This formula is applicable for all except n is equal to minus 1. So this is one formula. Now there are some other formula as well. Dy dx of sine x is nothing else but cos x. So integration of cos x dx is nothing else but sine x plus c. And why c? C is called constant of integration. Where c is called constant of integration. And why this constant is required? Constant of integration, and which value is not fixed now and indefinite. That is why this is called indefinite integration. Why? What is indefinite about it? Suppose I have sine x plus 7 and dy dx of sine x plus 7. The answer is sine x, derivative of sine x is cos x and derivative of 7 is 0. So here is cos x only. If you integrate cos x here again, then the integration cos of cos x is sin x and there is no 7. So that is why, because of uncertainty that there might be some constant in this function, we can add c, that c is that constant which is unknown, which is not definite. So regarding this indefinite constant which is unknown, we should write c, and that is why this c is called constant of integration. So keeping in mind, otherwise this definition will be wrong, that integration is a reverse process of differentiation. So that is why here we will add c and this c is constant of integration, which is written for a known constant which may be in the derivative function, right? May or may not be, not necessarily. So if there is no constant, then value of c could be zero. But we should write c and c for those unknown constant which may be present in derivative function. So that is why. So derivative of sin x is cos x, and integration of cos x is sin x. So similarly, if you write here derivative of cos x is minus sin x, so integration of minus sin x is cos x, or sin x is equal to minus cos x plus c, right? Now c can be positive or negative, anything, but we can write just c for sake of convenience. Dy dx of tan x is nothing else but sec square x. So integration of sec square x dx is tan x plus c, right? Now similarly, there are some other formula as well. Dy dx of cot x is minus cosec square x. Remember this. So integration of cosec square x dx is minus cot x plus c. Dy dx of sec x is sec x tan x is sec x tan x. So integration of sec x tan x is sec x tan x. So integration of sec x tan x is sec x. You know, so this type of formula is there, and you have to memorize all these formulas. And without memorizing this, it will be difficult to do anything. Cosec x is minus cosec x cot x. I hope you remember this. So integration of cosec x cot x dx is minus cosec x plus c. Similarly, dy dx of e to the power x is e to the power x. So integration e to the power x dx is e to the power x, and integration of 1 by x dx is log x, right? Now because derivative of log x dy dx of log x is what? 1 by x. So integration of 1 by x is log x. Derivative of constant is 0, but whenever you have to find derivative of a constant, say 2 is constant, and you know derivative of constant is 0, say 2 is there. So we can write this is 2, similar like x to the power 0, and similar like in differentiation, in integration as well, constant function can be taken outside. And as per formula, this will be 2 0 plus 1 upon 0 plus 1 plus c. So that is 2x by 1 plus c. So integral of any constant will be 2 is 2x. Similarly, integral of 3 is 3 dx is 3x plus c. Integral of 5 dt, since here dt, so it will be 5t plus c. Integration of 7 dy is 7y plus c. So the operator, according to operator, the function will come. If operator is for dx, then output will be in terms of x. If operator is dy, then output will be in terms of y. If in operator is in terms of t, then output must be equal to, in output must be in terms of t. So this is what the basic character of integration. Now in integration, similar like differentiation, this dy dx can operate u plus v plus w one by one. Similarly here in integration as well, if there is x square plus 5x plus 7, and then we can write here integration of x square dx plus integration of 5x dx plus integration of 7 dx. Operator can operate one by one, and as per the rule which we have learned, integration of x square is power increased by 1 divided by the same thing, since x to the power n, and 5 will be out x dx, and 7 will be out 1 dx. So what is that? That will be x cube by 3 plus 5 x square by 2 plus 7, one integration of constant is x. So 1 is x, 7 is 7x plus c. Since what is the formula? Formula is there that x to the power n इंटीग्रेशन dx इज x टू द पावर n प्लस 1 डिवाइडेड बाय n प्लस 1. सो हियर पावर इज 3, पावर विल इंक्रीज बाय 1 एंड डिवाइड बाय द सेम पावर. सो दिस इज बेसिक थिंग्स दैट इन इंटीग्रेशन यू शुड लर्न. सिमिलरली वन मोर क्वेश्चन आई कैन टेक हियर दैट 2x plus 1 whole square like this integration. So it formula will be applicable if and only if. Similar like in differentiation, you can go ahead with integration as well. And you can write it integration as 2x plus 1 power 3 divided by 3. And in differentiation, we multiplied by coefficient of x. Integration is the reverse process. So we can divide by coefficient of x plus c. So the output will be 2x plus whole 3 divided by 6 plus c. The other way in which we can do this by making substitution. So let me introduce the substitution. We can put this 2x plus 1 is equal to y, say. So differentiating both the sides, and therefore d by dx, d by dx of both sides is 2x plus 1 into d by dx of y, right? So what will happen? This will give derivative of 2x is 2. 2 will be taken outside, and derivative of x is 1. So 2, and derivative of 1 is 0. So 2 is equal to dy by dx. So it will better to write 2 dx, dx is equal to dy, or dx is equal to 1 by 2 dy. So we can write dx is equal to 1 by 2 dy. Now in this integration of we can write I is equal to, I stand for integration, 2x plus 1 whole square dx. We can write 2x plus 1 is nothing else but y. So we can put y, and it is a square, so y square. And in place of dx, we will put half of dy, isn't it? So half is constants, can be taken outside, and y square dy. So what is that? Half, and y square integration is y cube by 3 plus c. And if you resubstitute value of y, then it will be y to the power 6 by 6, y to the power 3 by 6, isn't it? Y to the power 3 by 6, 3 by 6 plus c. That is y is 2x plus 1 whole to the power 3 divided by 6 plus c. This is what comes here. You see that? So there is another method that is called alternative method. Alternative method. Right now? And this one is direct method. Even you can split this as a plus b whole square, and then you can do it separately. Integration of each and every term. So we can do like that also. Somewhere, so the substitution is introduced. Wherever there is no direct formula applicable, you can use substitution. For example, if I have to integrate, this is a question, that sine cube 4x cos x dx, then I can use here, put sine x is equal to t, and then derivative of sin x is cos x, and this is dt by dx, derivative with respect to x. And now, so cos x dx is nothing else but dt. We can write this cos x dx is equal to dt. In place of this, we can write dt. So that will be t to the power 4, right? Now sin x is t, so sin 4x is t4, and cos x dx is nothing else but dt. So that will be t to the power 5 by 5 plus c, and hence the answer is sine. Again, we'll resubstitute sine to the power 5x by 5 plus c. So that is the way in which we can use the integration by method of substitution. I hope you got it. Sometimes method of substitution is not enough, but we can write method of transformation as well. For example, if I have to calculate sine cube x, right? Sine cube x. So we can write it, that is 3 sine x, right? साइन माइनस फोर साइन क्यूब एक्स, यू नो साइन थ्री एक्स इज थ्री साइन एक्स माइनस साइन क्यूब एक्स, फोर साइन क्यूब एक्स राइट ना, साइन थ्री एक्स इज थ्री साइन एक्स माइनस फोर साइन क्यूब एक्स, माइनस फोर साइन क्यूब एक्स, दिस इज व्हाट, थ्री साइन एक्स माइनस फोर साइन क्यूब एक्स, गॉट इट। सो इफ आई हैव टू राइट साइन क्यूब एक्स, देन आई कैन राइट थ्री साइन एक्स माइनस साइन थ्री एक्स एंड होल डिवाइडेड बाई फोर, राइट ना। सो कैन वी राइट लाइक दिस, दिस इज डी एक्स। सो वी कैन राइट फर्दर इट एज वन बाई फोर कैन बी टेकन कॉमन, दिस इज थ्री साइन एक्स माइनस साइन थ्री एक्स डी एक्स, अगेन थ्री कैन बी टेकन कॉमन, सो दैट विल बी थ्री बाई फोर एंड इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ साइन एक्स इज माइनस कॉस एक्स एंड इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ साइन एक्स इज माइनस कॉस एक्स, इट विल बी प्लस कॉस थ्री एक्स एंड रिमेंबर डोंट फॉरगेट टू डिवाइड बाई थ्री कोफिशियंट ऑफ एक्स प्लस सी। सो द फाइनली आंसर विल बी ए 3 by 4, right now. So if you multiply with 3 by 4, this 3 and 3 cancel. So that will be 1 by 4 cos 3x minus 3 by 4 cos x plus c, and that will be the answer. So this is called method of transformation. What I said, this is a method of transformation. So this question is here, and this one method is called method of transformation. Method of transformation, not a specific, but we can transform and the function, and then we can use it for integration. So that is also where somewhere we will write a transformation and we can use it. For example, sec square x, if there is a sec square x, we can write it tan x easily. But what about tan x? If there is a tan square x, then we can write it as sec square x minus 1 dx, isn't it? And now integration of sec square x is tan x, integration of 1 is x plus c. So I am not able to find the integration of tan square x, but if I transform them in this formula, then I can integrate it. So this is possible, that some functions are not able to integrate directly, but if you will transform them, you can integrate them. Sometimes substitutions is required. For example, one more question I am going to take on here. Integration of log x by x dx. You can't integrate it directly. You cannot apply quotient rule. There is no quotient rule here. But you can use substitutions. And by using substitutions, you can do it. Put log x is equal to t. So derivative of log x is 1 by x and dt by dx. So we can write here 1 by x dx is equal to dt. So this dx by x can be written as dt and log x is t. So here integration will be t dt, and t integration of t is t square plus 2 plus c. And what is t? Log x whole square by 2 plus c. So this is also somehow substitutions is required. Depending upon the function, we will use in physics. And wherever we will use it, we will give a complete explanation there also. So you'll be able to understand definitely. But the basic things you need to learn quickly. And if you learn these basic things, then definitely you'll be able to go ahead nicely. Now, there is one more method that is called integration by parts. So, integration by parts for product of two functions, integration by parts. This is one very important rule which will be applicable, and this is for when there are two different type of function or similar type of functions are there, two function can be integrated by integration by part. If u and v are two function, okay, then integration of u and v dx is equal to u into integration of v dx minus integration of dy dx of u into integration of v dx and whole integration. So this is what the formula. I can give you the tips to memorize this. Phis d phis, phis integral d phis. It means first function as it is, integration of second. This is first function and this one is second function. So first function as it is, integration of second. Second is v. So integral v dx, that is integration of second minus integration of derivative of first and integration of second. Phis d phis, right now. So derivative of first into integration of second dx. This is what? Integration of second. Integration of second, derivative of first. Now the question is which one to be taken first and which one to be taken second. That is a question and that is coming in mind, that which one to be taken first and which one to be taken second. So depending upon the convenience, you can choose any one of them as first and second. Second function has to integrate, so those function whose integration is easy, that can be considered as second function, but those whose differentiation is easy, that can be taken as first function. But even though there is a rule which is given here, and that is called named as I let C, right now. So I let C, I have added. What is this? Pehle aao, pehle paao. First come, first services. I stand for inverse function. Inverse function. Right? L for logarithmic function, right? A for algebraic function, right? T for trigonometric function, and E for exponential function. E for exponential function, right now, and C for constant, right now. So depending upon the order, we can choose first come first services. Let us solve some examples in which you will be able to understand this, and what are those examples? Try to understand here. Some questions. Question number 1. I am taking here integration of x cos x dx. Here there are two type of function, and clearly these two of them are, one is cos x, that is trigonometric function, and x is an algebraic function. Here a comes before t. A comes before t. So we can take a algebraic function as first and trigonometric function as second. Now, as per this rule, integrating by parts, we can write here, integrating by parts, we get, what is that? First function as it is, here we write x cos x is equal to dx is equal to first function as it is, that is x, integration of second, that is integral of cos x, integral of cos x is sin x, minus integration of derivative of first d by dx of x is 1, and integral of second, that is cos x, integral of cos x is sin x and whole integral. So whatever you write here, that same thing you need to write here also, because here is also integral of second, there is also integral of second, is and is, so same thing. So whatever things will come here in integration of second, you'll use it without doing again integration of second here. Now this is x sin x, and there is integration of sin x. Integration of sin x into 1 is sin x, and integration of sine x is minus cos x, so it will be plus cos x plus c. So this is the way in which you can use integration by part. This is the basic formula. Sometimes here also say x square plus 3 into log x, like this. This is a question, and in this question what we will do, x square, say log x, and that is dx, right? So here depending upon this, logarithmic is first and algebraic comes after that. So this one is to be taken first and this one to be taken second. Now integrating by parts, we have to write here, what is that? First function into integration of second, like x square plus 3, first function, let me write this first. First function, that is log x into x square plus 3 dx. So first function to be taken as first and the sixth second. Integration by part, what will come here? First function is log x, so write as it is, first function as it is, as per this formula, right? You understand, right? Now first function as it is, first function as it is, integration of second. So log x as it is, we can write here log x as it is, integration of x square plus 3 dx. I'm just writing here integration of derivative of first function, so dy dx of log x. Without writing this, you can use it directly, and integration of second, that is x square plus 3 dx, and whole integration, so the dx again, right? Now this one is right again, so here dx whole integration, right? Now so what will happen then, using the same fact here, log x is same, log x, integration of x square is x cube by 3, and the integration of 3 is 3x, you understood it, minus derivative of log x is 1 by x, and here this is x cube by 3 plus 3x, so x can be taken common and it can be cancelled by this. So again this will be log x square by 3, we can write it like the x cube plus 3x and divided by 3 into log x, and if x will cancel here, x square will be left, and integration of that x square is again x cube by 3, and 1 3 is earlier, so it will be x cube by 9, right? Now and here x will cancel by this dividing x, 3 will be there, and integration of 3 is 3x and plus c. This will be the answer. So hopefully you got it, how to apply indefinite integrations formula, and that will be how to solve the questions related to integration. There are basically three methods, that is method of transformation, method of substitution, and integration by parts. I have discussed this in this all one by one, and hopefully you understood it. This is the basic knowledge you need to understand, because in physics there will be little bit application. There is a questions directly related to integration or differentiation or anything, but there is an application is a small application there. So you have to integrate, and this integration indefinite is also equally useful in definite integration. So this concept will be also useful in definite. So we will discuss when definite integration, we will repeat it again. So don't worry about that. Please try to understand all the basic things and learn the formula carefully. So if you learn them, definitely it will solve great problems, and you will be able to solve, understood in future, wherever it will be used in physics, their applications, you will be able to understand it easily. So thank you very much for watching this. Keep watching, and don't forget to subscribe this channel if you have not still subscribed this, Please subscribe it and push bell icon there so that you will get notifications as soon as video will be released. And there are more than 400 videos on our YouTube channel now. So you can get a lot of opportunity to develop and improve your knowledge. So thank you. Thank you very much. God bless.